Alright, so it's recently come to my attention that after all these years of having a YouTube channel, I've never done a crappy cartoon on Thanksgiving. And to be honest, I don't even know if it deserves a cartoon. I mean, every year it seems like Thanksgiving has been roughly the same thing over and over. Hey, what'd you guys do for Thanksgiving this year?
The same thing as every year. I ate like a pregnant person that was facing the end of the world, and then my Uncle Rick fell asleep on our couch drunk. What about you?
But Thanksgiving has to have a little bit more meat on the bone than that, right? I mean, they sure as hell made a big deal about it in my fourth grade social studies class, when we had to learn about the Pilgrims inventing the first Thanksgiving, which if I remember the story right, I think it was just about a bunch of dumbasses starving in Massachusetts.
Aw, man, this sucks ass. We should have brought some fucking food. Yeah, I know, but at least we got these sweet belt buckle hats.
And then, like, Squanto showed up and he's like,
"Hey, you stupid idiots! You have to grow shit in the ground or you're all gonna die!"
And then they all ate a bunch of corn, and there was like a fucking cartoon raccoon. I think Pocahontas had something to do with it. Yeah, because she had to fucking show Lewis and Clark how to get to Portland, I think. I don't know. I don't remember the details, all right? I went to public school. So in honor of Thanksgiving, aka the prequel to Christmas, aka basically Christmas without Tim Allen movies, I'd like to go over what a typical Thanksgiving's like in our household, even though it's pretty much the same thing every year. Now, it's important to note that my wife and I host Thanksgiving, and when you host Thanksgiving, there's a shit ton of things to do. I mean, not for my incompetent ass. I don't fucking plan Thanksgiving, are you kidding me? We'd be sitting at a fucking fold-up card table eating frozen waffles, for Christ's sake. Now, you see, like, weeks in advance, my wife turns into a four-star general, and she plans out this entire operation that is Thanksgiving dinner. All of a sudden, she's a fucking master tactician. Like, if her ass was in charge of the Normandy invasion back in 44, probably all her grandpas would still be alive, and there'd be no fucking Saving Private Ryan either. And I gotta say, every year, she makes Thanksgiving her own personal bitch. Like, if her and Thanksgiving went to prison, you could bet Thanksgiving's ass would be holding onto her inside-out pocket, and they'd go wherever she went. Move it, Thanksgiving. Fucking move it. I'll shank your ass. I don't give a fuck. But no matter how much planning she does beforehand, when it comes to the actual day of Thanksgiving, she's running around the house like a lunatic, looking like the beginning of a fucking Home Alone movie. And you know, I try to help her out, but, well, my dumbass cooks food at like a third grade reading level. What am I gonna make, a fucking bowl of cereal? Maybe a couple Hot Pockets for the Thanksgiving table?
What the? Who the hell made Bagel Bites for Thanksgiving?
Oh, that's me. I'm stupid as hell, so Bagel Bites it is. Bon appetit. Yeah, no, probably not appropriate for Thanksgiving dinner. So what ends up happening every year is I get delegated to what I like to call the dipshit work. You know, tasks that are so basic and trivial, even a dipshit like me can't screw them up. For example, I can stir a pot of gravy if you ask me to. Hell, I can do it clockwise or counterclockwise. I can also tell my wife when a timer's going off in the kitchen. I'm really good at that.
Hey, there's a timer going off. Something's happening. DEFCON 1. DEFCON 1!
But mostly my main dipshit work is doing crowd control for the cascade of family and friends that show up to our house. And they never show up on time. They just show up, you know, whenever the fuck they want. Hey, I know I'm not supposed to be here for another 12 hours or so, but I wanted to start drinking now. Now, usually I try to direct people over to the living room where we can take part in our yearly tradition of watching the Lions suck ass on national TV.
And after 47 unanswered points in the first half, we're just gonna say fuck it, the Bears won, and instead we're gonna air the Charlie Brown Thanksgiving episode.
Bum 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 bum.
Oh, what the fuck, Linus? You can't have jelly beans for Thanksgiving dinner? Good grief, I should fucking strangle your ass with that dirty ass blanket of yours.
Meanwhile, you got my father-in-law that's in the kitchen, being a backseat driver, or fucking backseat chef, if you will. Daughter, I don't think you season these potatoes enough.
Oh, really?
Well, I don't think. I asked for your fucking opinion.
Now, if you want to live to see Christmas, get the hell out of my kitchen.
Now, eventually, people find their way to their seats at the dining room table, and of course, there's never enough chairs to go around. So usually, I gotta run around the house gathering milk crates and fucking beanbag chairs and whatever the hell I can find for people to sit on.
Grandma, you're just gonna have to sit on this upside-down laundry basket. Don't lean back too far, or I'm sure it'll snap, and you'll break your fucking pelvis.
Finally, all the food is prepared in the kitchen, and I gotta say, it's a hell of a spread. I mean, my wife makes real cranberry sauce, for Christ's sake. None of that canned jelly bullshit. Hell, before we got together, I didn't even know cranberries were a real fruit. I thought they were just made up, like the fucking wampa fruit and Crash Bandicoot. And of course, the turkey is top-notch, cooked to a perfection. When she pulls that thing out of the oven, it fucking glows like it's some sort of artifact in an Indiana Jones movie and shit. Here's a picture of last year's turkey that I promised to show everybody. Yeah, fucking eat your heart out, Martha Stewart, with your goddamn
inside trading ass. Now, for whatever reason, every year, I'm the one that's nominated to carve this beautiful-ass turkey. I have no idea how this got added to the list of dipshit work, but every year, I gotta watch the same YouTube video on how to carve a turkey, and every year, I get so goddamn frustrated because this stupid asshole in the video spends the first 9 minutes telling me to like and to subscribe and to buy his fucking shitty turkey merchandise instead of, you know, showing me how to carve the goddamn turkey. It's frustrating as hell, and I usually just decide to wing it, which is a terrible, terrible, terrible idea. Because then I end up mangling the turkey 6 ways to Sunday. It fucking looks terrible. It looks so bad, I wouldn't be surprised if the cops showed up and was like, yeah, we've had reports that someone in your house is desecrating a fucking corpse. Who's carving your turkey? They're about to get charged with a 3rd-degree felony. But I serve the turkey up anyhow. People are looking at it fucking horrified. Aw, Jesus Christ, did you carve the turkey or did you try to fuck it? God damn, your ass needs to stick to the Hot Pockets and pizza bagels, holy hell. But regardless of what the turkey looks like, we all eat dinner, and it's delicious as hell. It's so good that everybody forgets about all the shitty furniture that I made them sit on. And you bet your ass that my wife makes sure that everybody eats all their food, and then gets more, and then maybe a little bit more, and even if they fucking feel sick, well, how about another plate? It's Thanksgiving, you piece of shit. Eat. You got people falling asleep at the table and shit. What's the matter? Did you not like my food? How about you have another plate? You only had 9. That's just trying to save some room. We still gotta go to my Aunt Carol's after this. Now, fuck your Aunt Carol. Eat my food. Eat all the food. I made it for you.
Eat the fucking food.
And then lo and behold, dinner's over. Everybody shuffles out to their fucking car, all bloated and lethargic. Everybody except for Uncle Rick, of course, who's drunk and passed out on our couch. And another Thanksgiving is in the books. So I hope everybody has a happy holiday. And if you're one of the unfortunate bastards that has to host, well, I hope you make Thanksgiving your own personal bitch as well.
And a happy Thanksgiving to you. Excuse me, did I tell you to speak? You will speak when I tell you to speak. Now grab my fucking pocket, you piece of shit. Let's go to the bathroom.
Brewstew.com.